Hello everyone, my name is Zi Yi Ye from Tsinghua University. It is my honor to be here to present our work. The title of our accepted paper is Towards a Better Understanding of Human Reading Comprehension with Brain Signals. This is a work of Information Retrieval Group in Tsinghua University. So, first of all, why do we need a better understanding of human reading comprehension? Reading comprehension is related to multiple information access tasks, such as information seeking and relevance judgments. In these information access tasks, a better understanding of human reading comprehension can be applied to inferring users' search intent, designing more proactive search interface, and constructing more efficient ranking models. However, the cognitive process of human reading comprehension is always very complex and involves many neural functions. This paper proposes to explore the neurological basis of this process and analyze how information application can consider these neural bases to boost their performance. We try to answer these three RQs. At first, we would like to explore whether there are any detectable differences in brain activities between reactions to key information and ordinary information. If there are differences, it is then interesting to ask what are their cognitive bases and insights for information retrieval services. Besides, we propose to ask if it is possible to classify answer sentence and allocate potential answer words with this difference above. To address RQ1 and RQ2, we conduct a lab-based user study where participants are required to perform reading comprehension tasks in the context of question answering. Then we applied event-related potential analysis to investigate the brain activities during reading comprehension. ERP is a typical method in neuroscience, and we will detail it in the following part. To address RQ3, we conduct classification tasks to explore the possibility of utilizing brain signals for automatic answer ejection and answer sentence classification. If the user's reading state can be detected automatically, information systems can better understand users' reading patterns and then provide satisfying information interactively. Okay, we first conduct a lab-based user study to collect brain signals during reading comprehension. We sample queries and sentences from a public Chinese QA dataset. We then recruit three annotators to provide human annotations of sentence relevance, answer span, and semantic related spans. For example, for a question of what is the largest mammal in the world, a perfectly relevant sentence is the blue whale is the largest animal in the world, and the answer span is the blue whale. The user study contains four steps in a given reading comprehension task. First, a question is presented on the screen, and the participants can press the space key to skip after reading. Then a physician cross and the words in the sequence are presented automatically in temporal sequence. And finally, an ordinary test or a special test is presented, and the participants should press a key to answer. The ordinary test is always, can this sentence answer the previous question? And a special test is a binary judgment involving the sentence. The ordinary test is to ensure that participants have read the sentence carefully and are able to judge the relationship between the given question and the sentence. While the special test is to ensure that even if the participants can make the judgment of ordinary tests beforehand, they should read the total sentence as well. In our user study dataset, each task Each task contains 10 words averagely, and users will complete 150 tasks. And finally, we recruit 21 participants. They accomplish 3,000 tasks and watch 30,000 word stimuli. Among these word stimuli, the ratio of answer words, semantic relative words, and ordinary words is about 1 versus 5 versus 12. The user responses in the collected dataset are then analyzed in terms of the accuracy rate and the reaction time in the binary decision test. We find that user responses are different in sentences of different relevance levels. And therefore, we can speculate that neurological factors may exist behind these differences, and it is essential to study. With the collected dataset, we conduct an ERP analysis to explore the neural activities related to human reading comprehension. Firstly, we give a brief introduction of ERP analysis. ERP is voltage generated in brain structures in response to specific events or stimuli. And it is a visualization of brain response to experimental stimuli. Different types of stimuli may lead to different voltages of ERP components. After that, we adopt a repeated measures ANOVA to analyze the difference of ERP in all time windows and regions of interest. The independent variable is three types of words. The dependent variable is the main signal in a given time window and regions of interest. From the visualization of ERP in brain regions of central, we can observe that there is significant differences between the grand average ERP waveforms of words across different types. Then we will elaborate our findings in detail. Firstly, we find that the N1 to P2 amplitude is higher in answer words, which indicates low cognitive loading when user locate the answer. Secondly, the findings in N4 negativity indicate that users instinctively expect answer and semantic relative spans in the sentence. And thirdly, it is very interesting to find that P6 is the highest in answer words, followed by ordinary words, while lowest in semantic related words. We suggest that this phenomenon is a mixed effect of inferential processing effort and semantic understanding effort. Our findings take an important step towards finding the nature of reading comprehension. And furthermore, we suggest that we can enlighten such systems to be more proactive and human-friendly. For example, we find that easily accessible contents of potential answers are important. So the ranking models should not only consider the semantic relevance, but also the document structure to re-rank the search results. And besides, the mixed effect of P6, it is the most interesting finding. It suggests that although semantic relative words are expected by the user, they also play a minor role in information recall and management. This suggests that although providing much semantic relative content makes a search result attractive, it is not always helpful to satisfy the information need. All results suggest that search engines should consider extracting SNPs by considering not only the semantic factors, but also factors related to whether the content can provide evidence for users' understanding. Note that we illustrate the insights of document ranking and SNP construction empirically here. It is also possible to model users' psychological behavior in a data-driven way with brain signals recording in the future work. And last but not least, we suggest that utilizing brain signals to acquire a better understanding of reading status is possible. If search engines can automatically understand which content can satisfy the users, it can further provide more helpful information interactively. To address RQ3 and explore the possibility of the BCI enhanced search described above, we conduct classification tasks with brain signals. We adopt the collected brain signals for automatic answer ejection and answer sentence classification. Brain signals are extracted as event-related potential-based features and frequency-band-based features. Here, we propose a unified framework for the EEG-based reading comprehension modeling. The attention mechanism is adopted to capture the local interactions of EEG features related to the sentence, and then different linear layers are applied as the output layers for sentence classification and answer ejection. Here, we present the experimental result of answer ejection and answer sentence classification tasks. We found that all models perform better than the random baseline, which suggests the benefits of brain signals. Besides, for different EEG-based models, our proposed model outperforms other baselines significantly, and the RNN model is secondly efficient. The results suggest that the benefits of sequence modeling in reading comprehension tasks. In conclusion, our work explores the differences in brain activities between reactions to key information and ordinary information during reading comprehension. We found several cognitive phenomena related to reading comprehension process, such as cognitive loading, semantic-semantic understanding, and inferential processing. Then, motivated by this phenomenon, we discussed some insights in the IR design to improve the user's experience. Finally, we conduct two classification tasks to automatically detect users' reading state. With the developments in BCI-enhanced search, we suggest it is possible to interactively provide helpful information in the reading process. In the future work, the first direction is from empirical to practical. Our cognitive findings with human reading comprehension provide several insights to facilitate the ranking model's construction and search interface design. Practical studies with the real-world search engines are meant to verify these insights and help us to rethink IR systems. The second direction is the real-life experiments. Although portable EEG devices contain much more noise than the lab-based devices now, we believe the technology will have a revolution in the near future. Thus, it is promising to collect brain signals in real-life tasks. And the third direction is BCI-enhanced search system. Chen constructed a BCI-based system for hand-free search scenarios recently, and we are encouraged to see the possibility of constructing a BCI-enhanced search system which can detect users' rating state and interactively provide satisfying information. Thanks for your attention, and we have done a series of works on using brain-machine interface to boost information retrieval performance. The papers, data, and code can be found in my personal website. Thank you.